In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a signup sheet using Google Forms so that you can easily collect names, time slots, and contact details for events, appointments, or volunteer tasks. So without any ado, let's get started. So first, open Google Chrome and click on this menu icon right next to your profile and scroll down to find Forms. Click on that to open up Google Forms. Then select Blank Form and provide a title for this form. For this tutorial, we'll use a volunteer signup sheet and we'll also rename this, and we'll provide a short description to help the respondent understand what this signup sheet is about. Next, let's go ahead and add our questions. So first we'll collect details like full name, and if you click on this dropdown, you will find different types of questions that you can change this question into. For this full name, if you want to collect the short answer, we'll also make this required, and we'll also do the same for email address. So I have added more questions. For example, we have phone number and we have choose your time slot. Here I'm using a multiple choice question and I'm providing different time slots for the respondent to choose from. And we can also make this a checkbox or a dropdown. Let's keep this as a multiple choice. And here also I have another multiple choice question. We can turn this into a checkbox. And at the end, I have a long paragraph question where the user will be able to provide a long answer. So a pro tip, in Google Forms, you can create multiple sections and redirect the user based on their answers to personalize the signup flow and collect even more important information without adding more clutter into this form. For example, if the respondent selects 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. as their preferred time slot, I can redirect that respondent to a section where I can ask more specific questions to collect more information from the respondent. I can also do the same for other options as well. And this method will work for any option-based questions such as multiple choices, checkboxes, or even dropdowns. So let's go ahead and add a section. We'll select the last field and click on this add section icon to add a new section. And we'll rename this section to be 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. time slot. And here to add questions, all I have to do is click on the plus icon. And here I can ask a question. Do you need any parking instructions for this slot? I can say yes or no. And I can also add another section. We'll call this as 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. time slot. And we can add a question. Are you available to arrive 10 minutes earlier? Now to set up the redirect, all we have to do is go to that main question and then click on the three dots and select this option, go to section based on answer. And here you will find this dropdown where you can basically select the section that the respondent will basically go to. So we can select this to be section 2, and we can select this to be section 3. So let's also add our banner into this form. So let's click on the design icon, and here we can change our font style from Roboto to Open Sans. And we can also add our banner image by clicking on choose image. Let's select this one. Now let's quickly explore some of the key settings that will help us manage the form responses much more effectively. So let's go to the settings tab, and here we will have this dropdown called responses, and here you will find this option called collect email address. Basically, if you want to prevent any typos on the email addresses the respondents will provide, you can set this to be verified, meaning they have to sign in with their Google account to start filling out the signup sheet. So let's keep this as verified. And we can also send a responder copy back to the respondent. So we can say always or when requested. And we can also set up response editing so the respondent can edit their response. And if you want to limit the response to just one person, you can use this option as well. Now, if you want to receive email notifications on new signups, you can use add-ons to make it happen. So click on the three dots right next to your profile icon and then click on get add-ons. And here we can search for notifications, and it will bring a list of add-ons we can add into this form. So let's select form notifications, and I have already installed it. So make sure to install it, and it will ask for some permissions. Click on continue and continue. Now, once the add-on has been installed, you will find this puzzle icon. Click on this puzzle icon and you will find the add-on. Simply open the add-on and it will pop up over here, and we can configure our settings over here. So we can say notify on form responses, and we can set the emails that will receive an automated response whenever a new form submission takes place. And we can also set this to be 1. Let's set save configuration. Now, every time a new form submission takes place, we will receive email notification to this email ID. So let's go ahead and publish this signup sheet. So let's hit publish and click on manage and make sure the respondent view is set to be anyone with a link so that the form respondents can actually submit the form. Click done and hit publish. Now all you have to do is click on this link icon and copy this URL and send it to your respondents, or click on the three dots and get the embedding HTML code and embed it on your website. And once you start receiving responses, you will see it over here. You can link the responses to your Google Sheets as well. So that's it for this short tutorial. I hope you found this to be valuable. If you want a better way to manage your signups, do check out Formastore. It's a free Google Form alternative that has tons of advanced features and also automation to make your work easier. As always, I will see you in the next one.